Welcome, dear listeners. I'm Victor, your host, and as a weekly basis, I will share news, articles, techniques, and tools that is related to cloud, software as a service, and infrastructure as a code security. Basic authentication for all Exchange Online tenants stops in October 2022. Microsoft had disabled basic authentication for POP3, IMF4, Remote PowerShell, Exchange Web Services, the Offline Address Book, Exchange Active Sync, SMTP Auth, and MOP. In addition, effective October 1st, 2022, Microsoft will begin to permanently disable basic auth in all tenants, regardless of usage. AWS Workspaces Remote Code Execution. This post details a vulnerability discovered by Rhino Security Labs in the AWS Workspaces desktop client, which allows commands to be executed if a victim opens a malicious Workspaces URI from their browser. This vulnerability could also allow an attacker to potentially pivot into an AWS Workspaces host by configuring process settings in the Workspaces client itself or keylogging usernames and passwords when a victim legitimately accesses their Workspaces environment. Revisiting Lambda persistence. Yuval at Palo Alto identified a technique to swap Lambda functions runtime during execution. This allows intercepting incoming requests that other users are making. If that Lambda function is a user-facing web application or API with an API gateway in front, it can potentially intercept credentials, cookies, or other valuable information. Default in our stars, security implications of AWS API Gateway Lambda authorizers and IAM wildcard expansion. In this blog post, Tenchi discusses one of the features of AWS API Gateway called Lambda authorizers and how the official AWS documentation might have led developers into using it insecurely. There are some recommendations and AWS reply included as well. How AWS dumps the mental burden of inconsistent APIs on developers. What Luke found was that there's no consistency between different AWS services, between related AWS services, and even within a single services API. The top four services are CloudFront, Workspaces, Redshift, and Cognito. Announcing the winners of the 2020 GCP VRP Prize. Google previously announced that they would reward the top 6 submissions in 2020 and increase the total prize money to more than $300,000. The article shares these top 6 submissions with links to details. Common AWS security vulnerabilities. Devansh tweeted about common AWS security issues, which are the following: subdomain takeover, SSRF to instance metadata, Cognito misconfiguration, S3 open bucket, Lambda Runtime API SSRF, API Gateway Denial of Service, and the last one is poor authorizer function. VMware Vulnerability Technical and Impact Analysis. A critical unauthenticated remote execution vulnerability was found in vCenter's analytics service that administrators should patch immediately. There are proof-of-concept exploits on the internet now, and technical details about the vulnerability also available. AWS Economic Investment Study. In this study, Amazon provided quantitative estimates of the direct and indirect economic effects produced by the construction, operation, and maintenance of AWS cloud infrastructure. Just two numbers, $7.5 billion and 1,000 full-time equivalent jobs over the next 15 years. Amazon Detective supports S3 and DNS finding types. Amazon Detective expands security investigation support for Amazon Simple Storage Service and DNS-related findings on Amazon GuardDuty, providing full coverage of all detections from GuardDuty. Stream Azure AD Identity Protection Events to Azure Sentinel. Microsoft recently released a new function that gives the option to stream events from Azure AD Identity Protection into Azure Sentinel. In this blog, you will find step-by-step instruction for exporting user risk events from Azure AD Identity Protection into Azure Sentinel. IAM roles for Kubernetes service accounts, a deep dive. Maciek decided to do a bit of research and document his understanding of his progressing when he had to figure it out how to retrieve data from DynamoDB from a pod running in their Kubernetes cluster. This article will show you the nuts and bolts of how IAM and Kubernetes work together in harmony to provide you with a great experience of calling AWS services from your pods. Deploy multi-cloud zero-trust Kubernetes in less than an hour. In this streaming session, IBM and NetFoundry teams demonstrate how you can use the open source ZT0 Trust software to build a multi-cloud zero-trust network for Kubernetes in a minute. Secure containerized environments with updated threat matrix for Kubernetes. Microsoft released the second version of the threat matrix for Kubernetes. The updated matrix adds new techniques that were found by Microsoft researchers, as well as techniques that were suggested by the community. They also deprecated several techniques which do not apply anymore to the newer version of Kubernetes. Extracting all the Azure passwords. Carfosen, DEFCON 29, Cloud Village. In this talk, Carr focuses on the password extraction functionality included in Microburst. He will review many of the places that passwords can hide in Azure and the ways to manually extract them. DEFCON 29 Cloud Village, Felipe Proteus, hunting for AWS exposed resources. In this talk, Felipe is going to describe some of the methods that researchers and attackers use to discover and exploit publicly exposed resources, and how cloud providers and defenders can have taken actions to monitor, prevent, and respond to these activities. Azure Sentinel Notebooks Ninja Series released. Azure Sentinel Notebooks Ninja Series released the second part of the blog post with a video, which is about getting started with Azure Sentinel Notebooks. Update for Microsoft 365 Security for IT Pros book. The authors just released the September 2021 update for Microsoft 365 Security for IT Pros 2022 edition book that covers all the Microsoft 365 related security products and features. There were some tools released this week that can help attack and secure your cloud environment. Azure AD Conditional Access Policy Design Baseline with automatic deployment support. Daniel's Azure AD Conditional Access Policy Design Baseline is updated at least twice every year, always containing lessons learned from the field. It is based on Daniel's recommendation of how conditional access should be deployed to create a strong zero-trust security posture. There is a manual and automatic deployment of the baseline. GitOps. As the description states, GitOps is a tool to help attackers and defenders identify lateral movement and privilege escalation paths in GitHub organizations by abusing CI/CD pipelines and GitHub access controls. It works by mapping relationships between a GitHub organization and environment variables in its CI/CD systems. Auditing used Power Automate connections. A quick and dirty PowerShell script by this, which will retrieve all current Power Automate flows and dump them into a CSV file containing owner, name of the flow, environment, used connection, so you can validate what kind of connectors are in use for your organization and what kind you need to add to your data policy. That's all for this episode. Thank you for listening and have a secure day.